Good day. I am Dr. Charlene Rubel Locay-Locay Ramos, the Executive Assistant to the Dean for International Students. And with me is...
And I'm Dr. Carla Motol-Malieri. I'm the Vice Chairman for Obstetrics and Gynecology for the International Students.
We are here to represent the University of Perpetual Health System DALTA, Las Piñas Campus in the Philippines. Well, the University of Perpetual Health has been existent for the past 45 years. The School of Medicine is an accredited higher education institution by the Commission on Higher Education back in the Philippines. It is under the autonomous regulation, which means it only been given to an institution with a long tradition of integrity, and the autonomous status has only been given to an institution with a long tradition of integrity and untarnished reputation, with commitment to excellence and sustainability and viability of operations. It is also an ISO-accredited institution, as well as a member of the WHO Directory of Medical Schools and Avicenna Directory of Medical Schools. So we are asked, why go to the University of Perpetual Health System DALTA in the Philippines for medicine?
Well, the University of Perpetual Health System DALTA School of Medicine is an outstanding center for excellence for medical education, training, community service, and research. So our goal is to produce quality and competent physicians.
During your stay in our medical school, during your first year, you will have or encompass and study the basic sciences, which are gross anatomy, wherein you are exposed to cutting cadavers, and also we have anatomage, which is the most technological 3D visual system for anatomy. You will also encompass physiology, biochemistry, histology, psychiatry 1, and preventive medicine and community health subjects in first year. Those are your basic sciences, and on your second year, you will be introduced to the clinical sciences, and third year, basically mostly clinical sciences. The clinical sciences, you will be arranged in our curriculum as an outcome-based education, meaning you will, the students will be graded using online examinations, paper examinations, as well as objective structured clinical examinations, wherein the student will be exposed on how to assess patients, introduce and assess a diagnosis and their management for the patients. Unlike in India, wherein your clinical exposure will be after your medical or MBBS degree, here in the Philippines, it will be incorporated during your four-year medical course. Wherein during your medical internship rotation.
Okay, so in your fourth year as a medical student, you will have your medical internship. Our medical school has a level 3 base hospital or a tertiary hospital, which has accredited residency training for different specialties like internal medicine, pediatrics, surgery, obstetrics and gynecology, radiology, anesthesiology, and emergency medicine. So these departments will help you enhance your theoretical knowledge and help you the basic and practical skills of becoming a physician. I myself is a product of the residency training program of the Perpetual Health Medical Center. I myself is a product of the residency training of the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology of Perpetual Health Medical Center, which is the base hospital of our medical school. So I was able to handle several interns, which are international students, when I was a resident, and also now that I am an active consultant in the department. So actually, I have seen some of my students now here in India. They were able to pass the MCI and the PG examination for residency training. And some of them are now in the residency training, some are already practicing, and Sam has his own primary hospital. So that is actually an evidence that we were able to produce quality and competent physicians from our medical school.
Plus, the spectrum of diseases in India and Philippines is almost at par or the same, unlike in other southern countries or northern countries, may I correct myself, is that here, we are same Asian culture and same spectrum of diseases, wherein you will be able to handle all your future patients with the same as well as you will be exposed in the Philippines. During your first year medical school, you will study cadavers during gross anatomy subjects. You will dissect those cadavers, as well as we have an anatomage table, which is the most technological 3D system survey in anatomy. We also have, during your stay, you can be guided and assessed for multiple choice questions during examinations, which will always be a 100 points system. And after your first year, you will go to your second year subjects, where the basic sciences and clinical sciences are combined. So during clinical sciences, you will be taught on how to assess patients, on how to diagnose diseases, and how to treat them. Firstly, we can guide you on how to be outcome-based because we are mostly outcome-based education. So we will assess you during OSCE, or the Objective Structured Clinical Examinations. And you will also be assessed by multiple choice questions and oral examinations, group reports, and as well as in your third year, before you enter third year, you will have comprehensive examinations. Those comprehensive examinations will be our guide or to assess you on how much knowledge you have gained for the past 2 years. And then after that examination, you will be able to get the third year. In third year level, it is mostly or entirely clinical sciences, namely medicine, surgery, obstetrics and gynecology, radiology, psychiatry, ENT, ophthalmology. All branches of medicine will be discussed thoroughly, and you will be taught on how to diagnose, assess patients, as well as treat all the most common and rare diseases. We will also assess you through multiple choice questions, group reporting, OSCE, and after that tier, you will have another comprehensive examination. It is a 200 points examination encompassing all the basic and clinical sciences, gauging your knowledge. And then after third year, you will enter the clinical clerkship, or what you have termed as medical internship. It is a 52-week rotation to the different clinical departments like obstetrics, gynecology, medicine for 2 months, surgery for 2 months, preventive medicine and community services for a month, and 2-week rotation for the minor subjects like ER medicine, anesthesiology, radiology. You can also opt to go to other places like the United States if you want to do your clerkship there. We are accredited and have a partner in the US, and we can also guide you if you want to do your clerkship in other states. I mean, in the United States of America, if you wanted to have clinical exposure, or if you want to have a future endeavor as a doctor there, we can help you with that. We also have an elective course, like a 1 month, 2 months course in ACIC, or it's a cardiology course in US. We also have students who rotated in Harvard Medical School with their medical centers and Yale University. We can help you with that. If you plan to take the USMLE, then we can guide you and help you on how to take it and when to take it. We also have students who are gladly have been finished with their USMLE and eventually now in their residency training program in the United States. The first, the top one foreign nationals in the United States is Indians. The second is the Filipinos. And comparing our population, we are less than your current population. So comparing our standards of education in healthcare, I can say that we are at most at par, or we can be globally competitive. So coming into the Philippines won't necessarily be a burden for you, because you'll be able to gain all the knowledge that you need when you wanted to become a doctor in the future whenever or wherever you wanted to practice.
So whenever you decide on going to, or during your clinical clerkship or medical internship, you will have clinical exposures to the different specialties that we mentioned. So for example, this is an example for the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology. We will teach you on how to do history taking to real patients, how to treat, how to diagnose, and also we will teach you on the different or different procedures and surgeries that we have. For example, in obstetrics, we will teach you on how to deliver an actual baby. We will ask you to assist during a cesarean section or other major operations, and that is only in obstetrics and gynecology. Just the same for surgery, ENT, and other surgical field, you will be able to assist firsthand during the operations. So I think this clinical exposures will actually help you to enhance your theoretical knowledge and also to teach you the practical and basic skills in surgery.
We hope that you have gained some vital information in medicine and how we carry out our medical education in the Philippines. We now encourage you to become a globally competitive physician in the future. Thank you.
Thank you.
I thank Advais who are trying to give broad information for the students who wanted to do medicine program in abroad. And for more information, please subscribe Advais.
I would like to congratulate Mr. Karunakar to start such an initiative, which will be available for all the students on YouTube.
Thanks to Advais, and please subscribe the channel.
And thanks to Advais. ఈ ప్రోగ్రామ్ చాలామందికి రీచ్ అవ్వాలి, ఈ అడ్వైస్ ఛానల్లో వచ్చే కార్యక్రమాలు చాలామంది విద్యార్థులకు రీచ్ అవ్వాలి అంటే సబ్స్క్రైబ్ టు అడ్వైస్.
హాయ్ అండి, నేను డాక్టర్ రామ్. థ్యాంక్స్ ఫర్ ఈడీవేస్ ఛానల్, సబ్స్క్రైబ్ టు ఈడీవేస్.
థ్యాంక్స్ టు అడ్వైస్ ఛానల్, ప్లీజ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ అడ్వైస్ ఛానల్.
హలో గాయ్స్, లైక్ ఫర్ సక్సెస్ఫుల్ జర్నీ ఆఫ్ యువర్ స్టడీస్ ప్లాట్ఫామ్ డెస్టినేషన్, సో ప్లీజ్ ఫాలో అండ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ టు అడ్వైస్ డాట్ ఇన్.
థ్యాంక్స్ టు అడ్వైస్, ప్లీజ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ అడ్వైస్.
I want to congrats Mr. Karunakar. I want to thanks Advais channel, and please subscribe Advais.
Please subscribe Advais YouTube channel.
Thanks to Advais channel. Please subscribe to Advais channel.
All the best for the Advais, and please subscribe the channel.
And please subscribe to Advais YouTube channel.
Thanks to Advais for giving me an opportunity to subscribe for Advais.
Thanks to Advais andi ee opportunity ichinanduku. Please subscribe to Advais YouTube channel.